Britain, yeah. But it's somewhere which in Britain we don't really.
Yeah, not really famous.
Not too famous, though.
No. But yeah, we. It's an amazing region. It's an amazing region. Yeah, seaside and most high mountain side in Italy. Everything in an hour drive. So yeah, it is a quiet region, but we have amazing product. We are from, we are famous for our arrosticini. We say that they are lamb skewers. Is that right?
Lamb skewers, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. They are amazing because it's just meat, so it has to be good meat, alternate with non-fat.
Yeah.
So you just cook it and just, I don't know, maybe I'm just too attached to it, but
you're lost for words now, aren't you? Because you start to think about the arrosticini.
Yeah, yeah. My mouth is starting to water. They're just perfect, just beautiful like that. We are famous for our pasta, and but everywhere you go in Abruzzo, even from town to town, I won't say town, from village to village, you have something different. So yeah,
it's a stunning place. I mean, I've flown over Abruzzo, and the colours, it's such a green, and the mountains are high, and you've got a wonderful sea.
Imagine in a small region, we have two national parks, two national reserves. Yeah, we can say it's a quiet region, but we have a lot going on, all in one place. So why don't you come and visit us in Abruzzo?
If anybody's working for the Abruzzo Tourist Board out there, you've got a new ambassador right here. Now back to the cooking. The apples are taking the colour quite nicely.
Yeah, almost ready. You can start to smell the caramelization of the apple and the butter and the sugar.
It's very much like bonfire night, that smell. It does remind me of like the fireworks, you know, the 5th of November. That kind of caramelized apple, it's really good.
Okay, so once the base for panna cotta is ready, what you do is you can put it in a glass to make your life easier, but it's nice to have some